Deciphering Decrement Indices. How S&P DJI's Decrement Indices Work. Low interest rates and dividend risk are two challenges commonly faced by equity-linked structured products. In recent years, many investment banks have turned to decrement indices, also known as fee indices, in an attempt to address these challenges and deliver more favorable terms for structured products. But what exactly is a decrement index? And how does it work? A decrement is an overlay applied to a given base index. Very often, the underlying is an equity total return index. A decrement index is constructed by deducting a predefined dividend, also known as a fixed synthetic dividend, at predefined intervals from the total return of its base index. While total return for a base index comprises price return and float realized dividends, from a decrement perspective, the fixed synthetic dividends and decrement index return compose total return. While the calculation route may differ, the end result is that a parity relationship exists between the two indices with dividends added, which could have important practical implications for end users. Depending on whether the fixed synthetic dividend is greater or less than the actual realized dividend received, the decrement index could underperform or outperform the corresponding price return. So it's important to select an underlying index that aligns with the objective of the structured product. There are two major methods to deduct predefined dividends: fixed percentage and fixed point. As its name implies, the former deducts a fixed percentage from the index returns, while the latter subtracts fixed index points from the index level. For example, an S&P 500 2% decrement total return index would subtract a daily portion of 2% from the total return of the S&P 500 each day. On the other hand, an S&P 500 20-point decrement total return index would deduct a daily portion of 20 index points from the decrement index level. So what does this mean when applied to a structured product? By eliminating dividend risk through a decrement index, issuers could provide more favorable terms at the structural level, such as higher participation rates and improved capital protection. It is important to understand that the gain on favorable product terms does not come without cost, as there's always a risk that the decrement index may consistently underperform its corresponding price return index if the decrement deduction is materially higher than inherent dividends paid out from the index. We constructed two fixed percentage decrement concepts on the S&P 500 Total Return Index, applying different percentages of deduction to help illustrate these potential risks. With a historical dividend yield of roughly 2% for the S&P 500, the 2% decrement version tracked closely with the price return of the benchmark, while the 4% decrement version consistently underperformed. Our hypothetical example underscores the importance of selecting an underlying index that aligns with the market conditions the structured product is designed to address. Since no two markets are alike, S&P Dow Jones Indices provides a wide range of choices for decrement index construction and deduction calculation methods. In fact, any of our standard or custom indices can serve as a base index, and all decrement parameters can be customized based on market participant and issuer requirements. For a closer look at S&P DJI's current range of fee and decrement index solutions, including the latest index mathematics methodology and decrement index parameters, visit us at www.spglobal.com/SPDJI.